The intro video.
So, starting off with my family, I have my beautiful wife named Fiona, and we have three triplets. They're so adorable. My best friend, he's a talking donkey, and is married to a dragon. They have some dragon babies. It's kind of hot. And wait. Mr. Bischoff, you're telling me I can't Shrek roleplay for this video? Mr. Bischoff, are you kidding me? Well, I guess I won't be needing this. Or this. Or this. Okay, guys, enough with the Shrek memes. Wait, Fiona, how'd you get here? So in terms of my actual family, I just have two parents, mom and dad, an older sister, and a puppy. Just got a puppy not too long ago. I work at good old Weaver Nuts Sweets and Snacks, gang. Stop by sometime. This old honker I'm in right here right now is my 2000 Buick Park Avenue. I love this car. Just actually got it inspected, so it's pretty cool. And we'll see how this year goes. I'm excited for this year of Effort AM, and we'll just see where Effort AM takes us this year. Let's go.
Effort AM, take 10.
Good morning, Effort. My name's Dylan.
My name's Annie. Today is Monday, September 30th. Please rise for a moment of silence and a pledge to the flag. It's that time of year. Be sure to check the daily themes for Spirit Week. Giving you guys a quick run through. Monday is American Colors. Tuesday is Meme Day. Wednesday is Taurus Day. Thursday is Color Wars. 12th grade is white. 11th grade is red. 10th grade is blue. And 9th grade is black. And Friday is purple and gold.
Any 10th, 11th, and 12th graders interested in Kutztown University? Looking for an opportunity to tour college campus? Join us for a field trip to Kutztown University on October 15th. Students will leave school at 8:45 a.m. and return at approximately 1:30 p.m. Be sure to pick up a field trip permission form from the counseling office and return by October 1st. Seats are limited, so be sure to turn your permission form in ASAP.
Today, a representative from King's College will be here at 8 o'clock, and a representative from Westchester University will be here at 9 o'clock, and a representative from Elizabethtown College will be here at 1:15. Any students interested in meeting with the representative in the CRC, please sign up in Schoology.
Reminder, tomorrow is the last day to submit field trip permission forms for the junior CTC field trips.
Calling all clubs and sports. If you're interested in speaking at the Fall Pep Rally to represent your club or sport in front of the school on Friday, October 4th, be sure to reach out to Chandler Eby or Jocelyn Umana for further information no later than this Wednesday, October 2nd.
Do you play League of Legends, Overwatch, or Rocket League, or are you just generally interested in Effort as esports? There is a rescheduled mandatory meeting this Tuesday, October 1st, after school in Mr. LoPiccolo's room 213 for those interested.
Attention, future leaders. You have the opportunity to be selected to attend the Hobie Youth State Leadership Seminar this coming May. Two 10th grade students will be selected based on their response to the following. Many leaders are determined and committed to a cause. Write about something you are passionate about and explain how you could lead others to care about your cause. Please submit your brief essay to the counseling office by Friday, October 4th.
I want to siphon your blood. Yeah, okay, blood drive signups to begin today during lunches. Be sure to sign up in order to donate and pick up the required forms from before October 11th. Now over to Riley with the news.
Not so pale.
You're on it.
In today's news, Elon Musk has announced a new spaceship design that more closely resembles the purpose of an airplane rather than a spaceship. As Musk notes, the rocket is rapidly reusable. This rocket is supposedly able to transport people to space, back to Earth, and back to space in rapid succession. SpaceX is calling their Starship the key to space colonization. On this day in history, in 1989, the Berlin airlift is officially ceased after 277,264 flights across Berlin. After the Soviet Union cut off most access to East Germany, the Allied nations had to find a way to get citizens inside the Berlin Wall for much-needed supplies. The solution was flying them in, making nearly 40 trips per day across the border into East Germany against the will of the Soviet Union. Now over to Natalie with the weather.
Good morning, Ephrata. My name is Natalie, and I'm bringing you the weather for this week. Today is Monday, and it's going to be a high of 68, and it's going to rain. Tuesday, the high is going to be 81, and it's going to be partly cloudy. And on Wednesday, the high is 89, and it's going to be mostly sunny, but there will be showers later in the evening. On Thursday, the high is 80, showers in the a.m. and showers in the p.m. On Friday, the high is going to be 63, partly cloudy, and at night it will be a low of 42. And on Saturday, the high is 64, it's going to be mostly sunny. And on Sunday, it will be a high of 70, and it will be mostly cloudy.
Yeah. All right, here we go. Good morning, Ephrata. I'll be bringing you the lunch today for the 30th. That's right. Looks like we have spaghetti and meatballs with whole grain Texas garlic toast. Looks like we have chicken bacon Swiss with a whole grain roll. Italian grinder. Looks like we have BLT with cheese and a whole grain toast. Chef salad, french fries, seasoned green beans, fresh baby carrots or celery with dip, chilled peaches, fresh fruit, or a slushy.
Love all.
Friday in sports, field hockey won 2-0 versus Garnspot, and football lost at Elko. Saturday, boys soccer lost 3-1 at Exeter, and girls soccer won 3-0 versus Exeter. Today, volleyball plays Calco at home. Now back to the main desk.
Anyone interested in being involved with the dance team here at the high school, signups are underway in the athletic office.
Anyone who is interested in joining a book club, our first meeting will be held on Thursday, October 3rd, after school in the library. This is different than Reading Olympics. You don't need to bring anything to the meeting. See you there.
Attention all ninth graders. Tomorrow, October 1st, the class of 2023 will be participating in a STEM summit hosted by an organization called Junior Achievement. During this day-long experience, you will be participating in games, experiments, competitions, and activities that relate to science, technology, engineering, and mathematics. You will be assigned to a team and a teacher to help guide you through the event, which will be shared in homeroom on the day of the STEM Summit.
Once again, it's that time of year. We are pleased to announce that this year's EHS Homecoming Dance will be held on October 5th from 7 to 10 p.m. Join us for a night under the stars and pre-order tickets during lunches for $10. You are also welcome to buy tickets at the door for the price of $12. See you then.
And now some words of advice from Professor Marzak. In order to understand mankind, we need to look at the word itself. Basically, it's made up of two words, mank and ein. What do these words mean? It's a mystery still to this day, and so is mankind. That's it for us today, Ephrata. Yeet.
Yeet!
Reach me.